Welcome to the channel Maths for Graduates. Today we will solve this problem which is little bit tricky. So I thought why not make a video on this question. So let's start. So we have to find limit of this function. Okay. So for that what we will do first, we will find expansion of this function. Series expansion for this function. Okay. So let me write. We all know that expansion for function log 1 plus x is x minus x over 2 plus x cube over 3 and so on. Okay, now let's divide x on both sides. Okay, so we'll have 1 over x log 1 plus x, so on dividing x will have in right hand side 1 minus x over 2 plus x square over 3 minus and so on. Okay, so from the property of log we can write this expression as log 1 plus x raised to power 1 over x. Okay, in right hand side we have 1 minus x over 2 plus x square over 3 minus and so on. Okay, so this logarithmic equation can be written as exponential form. Okay, we can write this as 1 plus x raised to power 1 over x equals to e raised to power 1 minus x over 2 plus x square over 3 minus and so on. Okay, we can also write this as, from the property of exponent we can write this as e raised to power 1 into e raised to power minus x over 2 plus x square over 3 minus and so on. Okay, now let me write this as e into e raised to power capital X. Okay, where capital X is this series minus x over 2 plus x square over 3 minus and so on. Okay, now let me again expand e raised to power x. Okay, so its series solution is 1 plus x square over factorial 2 and so on. Okay, so using distributive law we can write this as e plus e into x plus x square over 2 plus and so on. Okay, and in left hand side we have 1 plus x raised to power 1 over x. Okay, I hope everything is clear to you till now. Now let's subtract e. Okay, so on subtracting e on both sides we have 1 plus x raised to power 1 over x minus e, in right hand side we'll have e x plus x square over 2 and so on. Okay, now let's write the value of capital X. Okay, so value of capital X is series minus x over 2 plus x square over 3 and so on plus half minus x over 2 plus x square over 3 and so on whole square, and this goes on and on. Right, now let's simplify right hand side. Okay, so we have e taking x from this factor, we have x minus half plus x over 3 and so on plus, and taking x common from this factor we'll have x square over 2. Why x square? Because we have a 2 power here. Okay, so we have in bracket minus half plus x over 3 minus and so on whole square, and this goes on and on. Right, now taking this x outside this bracket. Okay, so we have in left hand side we have 1 plus x raised to power 1 over x minus e, and in right hand side we have e x, we have minus half plus x over 3 and so on plus x over 2 minus half plus x over 3 and so on whole square and so on. Okay. Now let's divide x on both sides. Okay. So when we divide x on both sides, we'll have 1 plus x raised to power 1 over x minus e divided by x. So when we divide x on both sides, this x cancels out, right? So let me write the rest of the terms. So in right hand side, we'll have e bracket minus half x over 3 plus and x over 2 minus half x over 3 whole square and so on. Okay, now let's find the limit. Okay, so when you find the limit, x tends towards 0, 1 plus x 1 over x minus e over x, and when we put limit in right hand side, we'll have e minus half plus 0 and so on, 0 into this bracket, this will also be 0, whole result will be 0 and 0 and 0, it goes on and on. Okay, so now we are left with, in right hand side we have minus e over 2. So this is the required limit. This is the solution which I found interesting. If you have some another solution, please let me know through this WhatsApp number. Thank you. Thanks for watching.